is an amazing story.
It sure is, Dad.
This is one of the coolest, funniest, and weirdest stories about Jesus.
That's right.
Do you even know what story I'm talking about?
Of course I don't know that.
What story is it?
It's the story of,
You don't have a clue, do you?
No, not really.
I didn't think so. Now, it happened in the city of Capernaum. Jesus had just arrived, and word spread quickly.
Pretty soon, the news crews were out and everything!
What are you doing?
Making helicopter sounds!
Helicopter?
Channel 12 News!
I don't think Channel 12 News was there.
No.
But there was a big crowd that had come. And there were so many people that packed the house, not even one more could fit through the door.
So they all got in the helicopter!
Now, there are these four guys carrying their friend on a mat.
Their friend's name was Matt?
No, his name wasn't Matt. He was lying on a mat. They were carrying one man on a mat. Not a person, a mat. Like a stretcher or a sleeping bag. Then they tried to get past the crowd of people.
Right! And the guy on the mat couldn't get up because there were too many people.
Actually, he couldn't get up because he was paralyzed.
What?
Yeah.
Oh,
and his friend was trying to bring him to Jesus. And they weren't going to let a little thing like a packed house get in the way.
So what did they do?
They climbed up on the roof.
Wait, why didn't they just use the helicopter?
Because they lost my helicopter. When they got up to the roof, they began to dig a hole in it.
Wait, what? Wait a minute. Is this really a rope? They just started to dig through the roof?
Yep. Roofs were made out of mud and tile back then. Much easier to dig through. Then they tied a rope to the guy's mat.
Ouch, that had to hurt.
I told you Matt wasn't a person.
Wow.
Then the paralyzed man's friend started lowering him on the mat through the hole in the roof.
So they lowered the guy down?
Yep.
That guy must have been scared out of his wits.
When Jesus saw that kind of faith the guy's buddies had, he was impressed and said, "Friends, your sin is forgiven."
But Otto thought they brought him to get healed.
They did. But Jesus was taking care of the most important thing first. It was much more important that we have faith and find forgiveness than whether or not we could walk around.
Otto never really thought of that before.
Now, when all the Pharisees heard him say that...
Wait, what does swimming fair got to do with anything?
What?
You said all the fairs in the sea.
No, I didn't. I said Pharisees, not ferrets in the sea. A Pharisee is a religious ruler in Jesus'
name. So they weren't
crying out
loud?
No. They were people who were very concerned about following all the Jewish rules. And sometimes they forgot that faith is what makes us right with God, not how well we meet a bunch of religious requirements. Can I get on with the story now, Ono?
Okay, gotcha. Pharisees, very religious and worried about rules. Go on.
So, when they heard what Jesus said about forgiveness, they thought only God can forgive someone's sin.
They were right about that.
Yes, they were. And since Jesus claimed to do it, they assumed he was claiming to be
God himself.
Right. Then Jesus said, "It's easier to heal bones than souls. But to show you that I can do the hard things, I'll do the easy ones too. Then you'll know I can really forgive you." your sin.
Let me guess. Jesus told the guy, stand up, pick up that mat of yours, and go home.
Exactly. And then the man leapt to his feet, picked up his mat, and began pushing his way through the crowd.
Wow. Everyone there must have been amazed and surprised.
Right. And the people began to praise and thank God. No one had ever seen anything like that before. The end.